Good morning, guys. It is round about 9 a.m. out here at Breckenridge. We got a beautiful day, lots of great snow out there, and today we're gonna be making some turns with none other than Mr. Ryan Knapton.
Ooh, it's beautiful out there.
Let's go make some turns.
Let's make some turns.
All right, Ryan, I got a question for you, man. What makes a snowboard fun for carving? What do you think are some essential things that make a snowboard good for carving?
Good for carving. First, I would like to say, I mean, as you will say, we can carve any board. As long as it has a side cut, you can tilt the board on edge and it can carve. Rocker, camber, any of that. Camber is a little more performance enhanced. Like, you get spring out of your turns, so sometimes you'll see me jumping out of the turns. That's a little, you know, energy feedback from the camber, where rocker's not going to deliver that. That's not to be said that you can't carve on rocker. So, you know, but camber is good. A bit on the stiffer side is good too, because you're not gonna, if you're riding at any speeds, your board isn't gonna noodle out on you. So I like a really stiff board, but slightly stiffer and is good, great for carving. Okay. And then,
So definitely, totally agree. Any snowboard can carve. You can get those clean lines with any board. But yeah, camber is gonna be a little bit more fun, a little more energy. A stiffer board is gonna hold up to those higher speed turns like you see Ryan throwing around. What about really laying over the board like you do, like the Ryan Knapton signature carves?
So with traditional freestyle boards, one of the main things that happens wrong for people is if you have a boot that's too big and you have a boot size that's wider than the board with using low stance angles, you'll have too much overhang of the board. And once you tilt the board on edge, you'll be hitting your toes and heels into the snow, and that just makes you fall. So I use a crazy wide board. I don't recommend people jumping up to the width that I use, but in general, wider boards are, you know, advantageous if you're interested in really tilting the board on edge. So the other end of the spectrum is you'll see our alpine riders with hard boots. They'll carving super good on narrow boards, but they use such high stance angles that they don't have overhang or heel overhang on their boards. So for freestyle boards, if you're going to be using low stance angles, then you just need to go wider. And it's not for everyone, but if you are hitting your toes or heels and want to carve deeper, then wider's the solution.
Absolutely. And just so everyone has an idea, how wide is your snowboard?
I use a 31.2 waist, and it's with 8.5 boots. So I'm on the very extreme end where no overhang at all, and I don't recommend that. But for most people, if you get on a 28 width board, it's going to carve so much different than a 25.5. And you know, you've ridden some 27s, 28s, and
absolutely,
so you have experience with that and with how much more you can tilt it on edge.
Oh yeah, so much. Even like just like 27 is a noticeable difference up from a 25. So the board I was on today was around 25.5, I believe. It's under 26 compared to Ryan's 31, so you can kind of see a difference in the carves there. But yeah, wide boards are super, super fun, so that's definitely a spec to watch out for.
Especially if you got like size 13, 14 boots. I sometimes see people in the lift lines where just so much overhang, where not even skidded turns are gonna really work for them because they're just hitting their toes and heels. So for sure, wide boots, wide boards. In general, I say if you're on 11 boots, but for sure, 100% if you're on 13s and up.
Absolutely, yeah, that's my cutoff as well. If you have an 11 or bigger, be looking at wide snowboards. All right, so last question for you, Ryan, man. What are a couple of things to look out for if you're trying to do these long, drawn-out turns? What's the best time of day, and what's something that you gotta watch out for if you're gonna be cutting across the slope?
Love this, because conditions are key. Often in my videos, you don't see other people, and you know, Breckenridge is one of the busiest resorts in the world. So all we do is tape in the morning, and then the rest of the day, once it's busy, then I just ride without trying to tape. But it's just too dangerous to be doing big, big turns back and forth across the whole run when it's busy. So very first thing in the morning, that's when the groomers are going to be best, and when you're not, it's not going to be as dangerous. But also just be looking around. If you're doing big turns, take care of everyone else and yourself on the mountain, and make sure you're not going to hit anyone and no one else is going to hit you.
Absolutely, that's it. Yeah, keep your head on a swivel, make sure you're staying safe out there. Yep. And get out early to catch that good corduroy.
Yep.
Awesome. Sick. Thanks, Ryan.
Yeah, thanks. Thank you. It's great to see you again, TJ.
Dude, so good to see you as well. I'll have Ryan's channel linked in the description below. Definitely check him out. He's got tons of great videos on there. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed the carves this morning. It's been super fun out here at Breck.
Beautiful conditions.
See you. Yo! One last thing I might add is that boards with directional features can be pretty fun for carving as well. A setback stance and a taper is going to offer a bit of a different feel as you're out there making turns. So as long as carving switch and like really laying out those turns switch isn't a priority for you, you could hop on a directional board and then you're also going to get that float and powder, which is nice. I hope this video helps you guys out and that y'all are having a great season out there. Thanks for watching and I will see you in a new video soon.